teachings, almost all teachings are given either to convince you that teacher is a great person or to convince himself that what he is believing is something truth. Teachings are given either to convince you that teacher is a great person or to convince himself what he is teaching is something great. Only then teachings are given. If there is no need for convincing, only techniques are given. And let me be very clear. Never learn from a person who has to convince about his authority to you. Then he will be talking too many big things which neither you understand nor he himself understands. Because he is in a big job of convincing you. If there is a need to convince the disciple, if there is a need to convince the student, be very clear, truth cannot be expressed 100%. If already the bridge trust has happened, then sharing the truth is possible. I always tell people, do not think, to doubt you need intelligence. To doubt you don't need intelligence, just intellect is enough. Yesterday, one devotee was asking me, what is this, Swamiji? Always you encourage doubting and questioning. But suddenly you change the whole trend. Yesterday you started telling, only fools doubt, only fools question. See, doubting, questioning is good to learn, but not to experience. If you just want to learn, if you want more and more words, if you want teachings, doubting is beautiful. Questioning is beautiful. But when it comes to techniques, doubting or questioning is not going to help. Straight away, if you want the experience, only the trust can help you. I always tell people, when intellect is ripe, it becomes intelligence. When emotion ripes, it becomes trust. When your being ripes, it becomes enlightenment. All teachings, either it is given as a commandment or given as a theory, one thing, at least with commandment, you know directly commands are given to you. But when you start reading theologies, in a very cunning, subtle way the commandments are inserted into your inner space, logically you are convinced. Logically you are convinced to follow these rules. Logically you are convinced about these teachings. Then great damage, permanent damage is done to your consciousness. Let me be very clear. Unless it becomes your experience, any teaching, it does only damage to your inner space. It does great damage to your consciousness.